All right, good morning, everybody. We're live in the side of the building here, the Fox 8 front yard, however you want to do it. AJ Petitti, always a pleasure.
Morning.
Every Wednesday, we try to do a shot out here or in the front yard talking about gardening, talking about the grass. We're giving you a garden update, but now we're heading into the time of year where our garden starts to have some fruit, right?
Fruits
of our labor, and that's when the deer start to show up. So
absolutely.
What can we do to prevent that from happening, and do you have any deer-resistant plants?
So as we're looking at your yard, we were talking with Zoom this morning. He's got deer literally walking up, knocking on his door, asking for a pancake in the morning. So as you look at the plants, there are plants that are fairly deer resistant. And these are a lot of perennials and some annuals that'll give you a lot of color really throughout the entire season. And these are pretty much, a lot of them are my favorites. So this is yarrow. This is a tried and true deer resistant plant. It's a perennial. It's coming in a lot of different colors. There's whites, there's pinks, there's yellows, there's oranges. But it blooms pretty much from early spring to late fall. As a perennial goes, it's hard to find a better value, something that's low maintenance and just really puts on a great show. So this is Echinacea, same as the herb. This also, again, is a very long bloomer. And you can kind of tell with the deer-resistant plants, if you could feel the leaves, they've all got a texture to them. So if you feel a plant that's got a leaf with a firm texture, a hairy texture, a prickly texture, they'll tend to stay away from those. And a lot of plants with a fragrance. So this is lavender. This is also a very deer-resistant plant. And because of this, this is because of its fragrance. So, we really love the fragrance. Deer don't particularly care for it. And again, these all come back year after year. So this is a great annual as we're coming through. So as you see these, and they're really starting to really breed and hybridize lantana very, very well. So this is an annual. It'll bloom nonstop all summer as you're going through. But again, it's got that textured leaf, but they're doing great colors with these as they're going through. This is a Russian sage. So as you're going through, again, something that blooms nonstop all summer. And these are all very, very low maintenance plants as you're going through. This is an annual. It's called a penta. So this will also, again, bloom all summer. Very deer resistant. And you could actually use these in the ground. In the perennials, you can put them in a container and then transition these into your yard as fall comes through. This is a heuchera. So these come also. So this is, the flowers are an attractant, but the foliage is really what the main star of the show is. So as you look at the foliage, they come in bright greens, neon greens, the deep reds, the burgundies, the rusts, and then daisies.
This was something interesting from last week, I believe. You brought this out, I think it was for other segment. What is this? I've never seen this before.
So this is Russian sage. So this
is Russian sage.
So it's a beautiful perennial.
Okay.
It gets nice and big. It actually really gets nice and full.
Okay.
As you're looking at it. So that holds up really well. And then Crocosmia is actually one of the coolest ones that I love. It's very deer resistant. It almost looks like a tropical flower in your garden. And so when you mass this out, it doesn't bloom all summer. It blooms pretty much mid to late summer. So pretty much where we are now for the next 4 weeks. And then if you are having issues, you can always spray. So it's important to mix up the sprays. So as you're looking at your different sprays, mix them up, switch them up about every 30 to 45 days. That way it keeps the deer on their toes.
So if you spray the garden with it, okay, and then how long does that last?
So typically about 3 to 4 weeks,
give
or take.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the plant skid and deer stopper liquid fence, they'll have a good residual on them.
Oh, really? Okay.
But you want to make sure that you just keep switching it up.
Some of it can
keep
stick
them guessing.
Good, right? Some of the stuff smells, some of it not so much, the deer spray. So
yeah.
Be careful with
the
it.
The liquid fence is the one that, personally, I can't use it.
You're
it's
right,
a little
right.
too strong
yeah,
for me.
Yeah, a little too strong.
So, and then looking at the garden, we've been talking about fungus, we've been talking about powdery mildew. It's starting to set in. It's not going to affect production. You can kind of see the flowers.
Mm-hmm.
The zucchini are still blossoming hard. We did have some whitefly come in this week. So I sprayed Captain Jack's with it.
Okay.
And that'll take care of the whitefly. You want to make sure whitefly is something that is very persistent.
Eggplant coming on a little bit here.
So you want to make sure that you take care of that. And then really just harvest.
Yeah.
I mean, we started walking through the garden this morning.
Right.
There was so much available to harvest. The cucumbers are great. The peppers are great. Zucchini's looking great. The arugula. The carrots we're going to give a little bit more time. The potatoes we're going to give a little bit more time. But it's so important to just make sure that you're continuing to harvest. Keep that production going. If you stop harvesting, that's when it'll start. Either things will go to seed, or if the fruit is rotting on the vine.
And we're also talking too that it's getting hot, and you want to keep watering your garden as well, even though we might not be getting rain nearly as frequently as what we did maybe 3 or 4 weeks ago.
Yeah, you want to make sure that you're watering every day, every couple days, depending on the weather. When it's, if it was cooler, I'd say every 2 days for sure.
Okay.
You know, here you want to just make sure that you're paying attention, and the plants will tell you.
Right.
You know, as you start to see them, if you start to see them wilt or look a little bit off, You'll be able to tell when you need to water them and how you need to water them. And again, the soaker hose is by far and away the best way to do it. You don't want to take a watering wand and spray the top of the leaves. Mm-hmm. You want to try to get the water as close to that base as possible, and keep the water off the foliage, because that's what'll cause, that'll actually create more fungus, more disease issues.
Gotcha.
So you want to keep that stuff off the foliage, down towards the bottom. And actually, soaker hose is so much easier. Once you loop it around,
right.
You just turn the faucet on, leave it on for 10, 15 minutes, turn it off,
sure.
And it just makes life so much easier.
Or get a timer for it, either way.
Yeah, if you get a timer, then you don't even have to worry about it. Right. It'll set it for that much every day, and then you don't even have to think about it.
Good stuff, AJ.
Beautiful.
Always a pleasure. Send it back to you guys.
Great, thank you guys.
Yeah.
Basil, carrots, tomatoes, they're
very
doing
nice.
Good,
right? All this talking about food is making me very hungry.